You're probably familiar with SQL Server Agent jobs, but have you seen how you can create, maintain, and manage them using notebook jobs in Azure Data Studio? Learn more in this episode of Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed MVP Edition. Today, I'm joined by an MVP, Taiob. Thanks so much for joining us today. Can you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Thank you, Anna. I am a data platform MVP. I've been working with mostly Microsoft data platform, data stack for almost 15 years. So I started my journey on premises, and in the last four or five years, moving into cloud. So currently in a hybrid state. Also, I do a lot of stuff with the community. I'm engaged with two user groups. SQL Saturdays, and also due to pandemic, speaking in a lot of groups all around the world, mostly remotely, and on the topics of data platform.
Awesome, cool. Well, thank you for joining us today, and thanks for all that you do for our community. I know it's a super big part of, you know, kind of everything that happens in the Azure SQL and SQL Server world, so thank you for that. Today, we're going to be talking about something pretty new to me called notebook jobs in Azure Data Studio. So I wanted to ask, start by asking you a few questions. You know, people have been using maybe SSMS or other ways of managing SQL Server Agent jobs for a long time. So why or what benefits do folks get with this new capability, notebook jobs?
Sure. Yeah. I mean, I personally been primarily be using, you know, SQL Agent for scheduling jobs for years. And recently with Azure SQL Database, we've been looking at other options. But the primary advantage when I saw that I can schedule a notebook is to save the output. To give you an example, you have a crisis, you get up at morning 2 o'clock, you are triaging an issue, you make some changes, and you go on. So next day, sometimes you don't remember, right? It was early morning 2 o'clock, you just got a call. So if all of the team members have these notebooks shared with them, you know, pre-configured, they can run this pre and post and save that, right? And you can schedule that as a job. Either it runs at a frequent interval or you can run it on demand. So if you have your configurations, you have to save it once a day, once a week, then you can go back and see those changes that what you change. So you can schedule a notebook, it will save your output, it will save all the outputs, you know, for as long as you want to keep it. So that's one of the main advantage I found. And if folks, probably many people know, many people might not know, Tiger team actually is putting all their scripts in notebooks and sharing with the community for a similar purpose.
Gotcha. Okay, so notebooks are super useful. I definitely agree with that because of the saving of the outputs. But this other capability is the ability to kind of schedule them and kind of store the results in maybe different places. Does this functionality come like built into Azure Data Studio?
So it does not come built in into Azure Data Studio. It doesn't come built in into SQL Server or Azure SQL Database. So I'll show you extension in Azure Data Studio that you first have to load. It's still in preview. It's written by Microsoft. And once you have that extension enabled, then you get this capability.
Okay, gotcha. So not super difficult to get. You just have to go get an extension in Azure Data Studio. Awesome, cool. And does this work? You mentioned, you know, something about Azure SQL Database. Does this work in Azure SQL Database or Azure SQL Managed Instance?
So natively, I cannot create a job for Azure SQL Database, but I can do it for Managed Instance because Azure SQL Database doesn't have a SQL Server Agent. So today, if you want to run a notebook, you can do with the invoke notebook SQL notebook. There's a PowerShell command. And I also have a example in the demo script that I shared. You can do it there, but you really cannot schedule the way you can do it against on-premises SQL Server.
Okay, got it. And if you wanted to do this scheduling capability with Azure SQL Database, since you know you don't have SQL Server Agent, that's really why you can't use this. There are other things like Elastic Jobs, Runbooks, automation that you could use. Okay, cool. So I would love to kind of see this in action. I've never seen it before. Do you have anything you can show us?
Yes, I can, definitely. Let me share this with you. Okay, so this is a notebook I wrote this in Azure Data Studio in SQL kernel. If you're familiar with notebook, that you know you can write your notes. So I have some prerequisites for this to work. And before I do any of this, I'm going to show the extension. So there's two ways you can get this extension. One is if I type here agent, this is the extension that you have to enable, and then you get the functionality that I'll be talking about. There is also something called admin pack. If you have admin pack actually comes with four different extensions, and SQL Server Agent comes with it. So you do not need that to load separately if you already have it.
Nice. I actually didn't know there was an admin pack. So that's kind of cool. You get all those things in one extension.
Yeah, you get all this for. So I'm going to close this. So once before we want to run this, we need to decide a database. It can be an existing one, or you can create a new one. This will create two tables. One is NB template and NB materialized. And one will store the definition of the notebook. So the SQL Server agent can pull that definition when it runs the job. Other one is going to save your results from each run. So I'm just going to create an empty database called notebook jobs here. Once I'm done with that, now I'm going to create the notebook job. And I'm not going to read all these details. I also put a link here so you can see all the features into the job in details, what does what, just in case if you're interested. And the jobs by default take the name of the notebook. So I'll just run a script to delete it in case if you already have a job with the same name. You'll get an error message. And here I'm going to go to the, run a notebook job, set it up, and then we'll look at the output. So this is the connections for your server. So this is my default instance in the machine that I'm using. If you right click and you go to manage, you see something called SQL Agent. And once you click this, let me get some real estate, turn this off. Now, this is exactly you are seeing what's in your SQL Server agent, the jobs that you have already configured. So I do not have any jobs. I just have one that comes by default. Now, if I click on the notebook, here I can see if I have any jobs that created with the notebook. The one you saw actually was testing it before this, so I cleared it up again. Now we can say create a new notebook job. And here you point what notebook you want to run. And we'll see this notebook, what it's doing. So I'm saving my database configurations, right? And I can save this maybe once a week. So in case if something goes wrong, I can go back and see what was my previous setting. Or if you are making a major deployment, you probably want to save this before so you can compare it after that. And for my storage database, as I said, you can choose anyone. But in my case, I'm just going to choose notebook jobs. I'll run it against master database as I'm collecting all the configurations. As you see, the name was taken from the notebook name. Now, one thing, I can pick a schedule here, whatever schedules I have available. But I cannot create a new schedule. So if you need a new schedule, you should create it in your SQL Server agent using TSQL, PowerShell, or from the GUI, and then you can pick it up here. And I'm not going to do one, so you can put a description here. And okay, so now we have it. If we have created a schedule or picked a schedule, it will run on that schedule. We could also run it manually from here.
Cool, pretty easy to set up, it looks like.
Yeah, and once I'm done, now this is the beauty of this. The output is saved in another notebook. And I can open this here. Now you see my notebook. That's why I didn't show it to you before. This was my notebook. Simple, it's just collecting a system configurations, and now I have the output. So I can save this before or after, run this, save it, and I can email it to someone if I need to share it with my team or to some other business partners or whatnot. I can do alerts, operators, proxies. The only thing I can do from here is the schedule. As I said, you have to create your own beforehand. And now if I refresh it, I'll see two jobs. These are each runtime. A longer green bar means it ran longer compared to the shorter ones. So, and if you do not put a path, the output by default gets saved where my notebook was. So as you can see here, with the timestamp, you will get underscore output. That's another notebook. And there is another place it gets saved. I actually put it in my, if you go here, you can just grab that output and you can send it to someone. We'll quickly look at the metadata, what those two tables that I talked about. So as you can see, the first one has the metadata, it's in a JSON format. The notebook itself is a JSON file, nothing else. So It has all the details. This is our runtime, what time we last ran it, was it successful, did it fail? And as we talked about before, invoke SQL command, it has a, you can run this with this PowerShell command, and you can automatically open this in Azure Data Studio with the open editor file. I put three examples here. One is for default instance, one is for named instance, and one how you can run it against Azure SQL database by proper authentication. I also put some references here if you want to read more details. And there are still some issues that I send it to the product team. And once I get those resolved, I'll probably update this in my GitHub.
Awesome, so cool. Yeah. This has been really useful. I've learned a lot. I hadn't seen these notebooks in action really before. I had seen the PowerShell command, but I haven't seen that GUI that you showed that makes it really easy to kind of set these up, schedule them, analyze them. And what I love is that it's storing those notebooks as new files. So it was actually going to be one of my questions. I don't really want to just keep overwriting this notebook. That's not necessarily valuable. But now that you have a log, you can kind of compare, like you said, before a big change happens or after a big change happens, make sure things are still running however it is that you want from the job. So that's really useful. Is there any limitations or kind of gotchas people should be aware of as they get started with this?
Yeah, one limitations people have right now is with the named instance. As the product team is aware of it, you cannot schedule this to a named instance from the GUI. That's why I put an example with the invoke SQL runbook that you can run it manually for now. Or of course you can schedule it within this Windows scheduler, or if you have other scheduler. And you can take it further actually, instead of creating a notebook, or you can also take it, write it to a database table, right? Your output using your notebook with a date timestamp. So you can, that way, we are database people, right? So easy to compare, right? So what changed and what didn't change. And with invoke command, you can actually put date and timestamp to your output file also. I was not able to do that from the, from the GUI. So here, if I'm, running it many, many times, I can have date timestamp happen to my file name. That would probably be easier to sort and all that.
Cool, awesome. Well, this has been really useful. I think always something to keep in mind with Azure Data Studio is that the team is investing so quickly and innovating so quickly that by the time you watch this video, some of these limitations we're talking about might not even be there anymore. So definitely go check it out. Taiob, you have some great resources in that notebook. We're gonna put a link to that GitHub page in the description. So definitely go check that out. I'm going to go take a look because it looks like you've got some helpful comments and resources in there. I just want to thank you so much for coming on the show. This was great. I learned a lot, and I think our viewers did as well. For our viewers, if you like this video, go ahead and give it a like, leave us a comment, and let us know what you're going to do with notebook jobs. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.